In the 1998 war-themed film Saving Private Ryan, there's a gripping scene where a soldier, the medic Irwin Wade, is shot and drops to the ground. His companions quickly gather around him, urging him to stay awake as he bleeds badly. Assuring him that he'd be taken to a medical facility and that everything would be okay, they try to keep him conscious by any means necessary. This familiar scene, often mirrored in other films and even in real-life situations, speaks to a widespread belief that it's crucial to keep a gravely injured individual awake, and that failing to do so can be fatal. But how accurate is this belief? More importantly, why is an injured person generally encouraged to remain conscious? The idea that a critically sick or injured patient must remain conscious is primarily a non-medical concept. In other words, it doesn't hold significant scientific credibility, but has nevertheless become a part of our shared consciousness. This belief is largely perpetuated by how rescue missions and first aid delivery are portrayed in films and the wider pop culture landscape. With the cinematic importance of inducing strain and emotion, telling a wounded character, "Don't let go, just stay with me," makes for a dire, yet powerfully emotive scene. Nevertheless, it's crucial to remember that injuries vary, and there are circumstances where it's beyond an injured person's control to stay conscious. An example of such a situation would be a severely bleeding individual who loses consciousness due to critical blood loss. While there are times when keeping an injured individual awake isn't medically beneficial, it doesn't mean that it offers no advantages. One clear benefit is its provision of reassurance, especially to the rescuers. When a victim is responsive and can communicate, anyone aiding them can be entirely sure that they are still alive. Moreover, an alert patient can also share crucial details, like how they were hurt and where their pain points are, which can tremendously assist medical professionals in optimizing their emergency treatment methods. To put it in simple terms, a conscious and communicative patient can better explain their injury, particularly internal ones, than if the doctor has no readily available information. There is also a considerable advantage in having a conscious patient when it comes to their airway. Medical professionals can be assured of a functioning airway if a victim is conscious and can therefore concentrate on treating the original injury. In contrast, an unconscious victim's airway requires attention, in addition to their injury, to avoid any complications. Some injuries, particularly those to the head, can lead to a decline in cognitive abilities over time, especially if the patient doesn't receive immediate medical attention. In such cases, asking basic questions like "What's your name?" or "What day is today?" provides a handy means to monitor any cognitive functional changes. Lastly, maintaining consciousness can make a significant difference in life or death situations where a victim might be stranded in harsh and cold environments. If an injured individual stays awake, they can keep their body moving, thereby generating body heat, which can be critical for survival. However, if the individual becomes unconscious or falls asleep, this survival advantage is lost, particularly if their rescue takes a long time.